Hey, it's Chris, creator of the free responsive WordPress web design tutorial training series, and also founder of Badgett Web Design, where we help businesses and people either go through a major website online presence redo or get their very first website up online, looking good, built on solid marketing fundamentals and really authentically representing the brand or person or business. So I'm out in Montana, and I really look forward to this program I'm about to share with you. Share it with your friends. No need to opt in or give me your email address. This is a totally free, no strings attached video training for you. I hope you get a lot of value out of it, and I hope that you're able to get a pretty solid online presence and good experience for your customer or whoever you're trying to reach through online. So enjoy the video training, and thanks a lot for stopping by. Hey, it's Chris. In this video, we're going to go over all the different things you're going to learn in this program, and we're also going to talk about just generally how the internet works in general, because there's a lot of misconceptions surrounding how the internet functions and websites. So once you understand that and kind of see all the moving parts, building a website for your business or personal site, a lot of the details will make a lot more sense. So first I'm just going to talk about the sitemap. Sitemap is sort of like an outline or a mind map of how you organize your content. Before you ever begin buying domain names and actually constructing a site, I recommend that you organize your content in an outline format or a mind map format if that works for you, or even just in paragraphs on a Word document. You've experienced a sitemap when you've been to a website, when you see their menu structure and kind of how the content is organized. It's important to remember that you may have a lot of expertise or knowledge about your business or your information, but the general public may not. So it's really important to organize your content with intention so that when the end user arrives at your site, that they can clearly navigate your site and understand what it's all about very quickly. So if you on any website, the menu is a place to look for a sitemap. Other websites actually have a link where you can see the sitemap, which is a will kind of look like an outline with different hierarchies involved in that. So what I recommend you do is open up a Word document and you want to organize your text. So you can just create an outline or use a text editor or whatever software you're comfortable with and just add the words to that document that will be on individual pages and organize that. You can also do that on a piece of paper with a good old-fashioned pen or pencil. And then I also recommend you kind of organize other media that may get involved in your site, whether that's images or video files or audio files, and maybe those things are already existing on other sites like YouTube, and sort of create folders for different pages or areas of your site and organize all your content. So essentially what you're doing is creating a sitemap. The next thing you really want to think about is your domain name. So you've got this content, you've got your idea. Another great thing about organizing your content first is that you've already put a lot of time and effort into figuring out what your site, what your business is all about. And if you don't have a domain name already, that you're coming from a place of organization for selecting the name of your website. If you already have a domain name, this step's already done. If you're the type of person who really likes to ready, fire, aim, and just jump right in, buy the domain name, start building out the site, you'll figure out the content later, that's okay too. But I definitely recommend doing some kind of at least brainstorming around your sitemap before you go to purchase a domain name if you haven't already. You may get some ideas about what to call your site from just kind of diving deep into your content. So in this training, we're going to go over how to buy a domain name from GoDaddy or Bluehost. You can buy your domain name at lots of different places, and even if you end up getting hosting somewhere different from your domain name, that is possible. I recommend you kind of get them at the same place from a provider like GoDaddy or Bluehost. But a domain name is essentially just a registration of that name.com that's unique. There's nothing else like it on the internet, and that is your signature. So if that .com is not available, you might have to get creative on the wording or go for the .net or the .org. We'll go over that in a little more detail in the domain registration training of this series. So you've got your sitemap, you've got your domain name. The next thing you need is hosting. So what hosting is essentially is, think of it in simple terms as a computer or a hard drive somewhere else in a warehouse in the desert that actually holds your website. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is, you can host your own website on your computer at home, but that would mean that your computer would have to be connected to the internet and could be getting huge surges of traffic, and people actually visiting your website on your home computer in your house. That is possible, but most people choose to go with a professional hosting account like GoDaddy, which ends up being something around $50 to $70 a year at the time of this recording for your hosting account, with the domain name being about an additional $10 a year or something like that. So think of it like this. You have a hard drive waiting out in a warehouse in the desert that anybody in the world can access the files on that hard drive, which create your website. They can find it through that domain name that you select. And that is what hosting is all about. It's about the container for your files or your content, the actual hardware that holds your website. So that's what hosting is. Content, can take many forms, but, as we discussed in the sitemap, really, it's good to start with text. You've got audio content, video content, image content. There's all different types of those things. For example, a photo can be in JPEG or PNG format. Text content can be text on a page. It can be a downloadable PDF document. So there's all different shapes that content can take. It can be free, it can be for sale. You may want them to join your mailing list, your email list, before they can access certain pieces of content. So start thinking about your content. Think about it in multimedia forms. What I mean by that is, some people may prefer to consume your content by text. Some people, which means they like to read. Some people may want audio, which means they may like to listen, or they're short on time and they want to, listen to your content while they're at the gym or driving to work. Video is another one. Video, is quickly taking over the internet as far as bandwidth. YouTube is the second most trafficked website in the world at the time of this recording. And what that means, is people want video. It's a great format. They can consume the content passively, in the sense that they just press play as opposed to actively sitting there and reading the content. So think about your content, and if you're just going to put that content on that hosting account with no way to, if you don't come from a programming background, that would be very difficult. So that's where WordPress comes in. WordPress is a content management system that lives on your hosting account. It's a piece of software, it's an application that you install on your hosting account to actually make it easier for you to manage your content and make it, you know, make it look presentable to the public when it's actually displayed and up for consumption or viewing or whatever you want to call it. So that's what WordPress is. It's a content management system, and it kind of functions on two levels. One level is for design. With WordPress, you get something called a theme, which gives your site a general feel or brand, and you can adjust colors and options so you can make your site look unique. And the other is just the actual infrastructure and the way the site functions. If you want you know, your menu to work in such a certain way, or you know, you want to you know, upload new pieces of content, if you didn't have WordPress, you would really need a programming background to figure out how to do this stuff with, you know, get into coding. WordPress allows you to interface with basically programming without knowing how to do it. It does it for you in a more user-friendly interface. So that's what WordPress is. That's what content management is all about. And that's a general overview of how websites and the World Wide Web work. And if you really think about it, if you really drill down and think about the power of becoming your own publisher and creating content that's valuable to people and helpful, you know, having a well-done website on the World Wide Web literally puts you on the same playing field as major publishers. It is possible to have global impact with a well-done website. So the days of, you know, the gates of getting, you know, out to the public your message or your ideas or your digital information have been lowered. There's no more barriers between you and getting your message out. And that is what makes building your own website so powerful. So I hope you enjoy this video training on how to do that. If you're, you know, feel like you already have some good technology training in your background, you're going to move through this real quickly, and I bet you're going to wish you had figured this out sooner. If you're new and are feeling a little intimidated about what's coming, don't worry. The training is step by step on how to build a website from scratch with limited or no knowledge. So you will, at the end of this program, have a fully functional, beautiful website. Thank you.